everyone. Today I'm going to be talking about my Polaroid Instax Mini 8 camera, how I take my pictures on it, what do I do with my pictures on it, and how this camera actually works if you're interested in buying it, if you already have it and you're a little bit confused, because I know I was a little bit confused when I bought it. So this is going to be a guide to this camera and Polaroids in general. I love Polaroids because if you don't know what they are, it's a camera that prints like a physical hard copy of a picture. So I just took this one really quickly right now. And what it does is when you take the picture, you hit the shutter release and then it actually will print you the picture. And it doesn't save the picture anywhere digitally. You only get a physical copy, which I think is really cool because that's the way that they did it in the old days. And it like brings back a little bit of a nostalgic feel, even though this is like a new camera that they... It's like a new technology. I don't really know how to explain it. Clearly, I have a lot of Polaroids. I literally just dropped them all. So let's get started with talking about this camera. The way that it works is, it is just you go online and you can order it on Amazon. I would definitely recommend ordering it on Amazon because I know they sell this camera at Urban Outfitters and a lot of you might be tempted to just go there and buy it, but it is $100 at Urban Outfitters, probably more than that now that I'm thinking about it. I think it was $115 when I went last time and I looked. But on Amazon, I paid $65 for this brand new, ship from Amazon directly, not from like a sketchy seller or anything. So that's pretty good. This comes in a lot of different colors. It comes in yellow, pink, white, and I'm pretty sure a few others, and obviously this blue color. I love this. What you do with this camera is, it's really, really simple. So what you do is you're gonna load your film on the back here. I'm not gonna be showing you guys how to load the film today just because otherwise it will expose all my film and I won't be able to get any more uses out of it. So I don't wanna do that. But the way that you use this camera is, there is a little lens hole back here. So you look through the hole when you wanna take a picture and you open the camera by pressing this little nudge thingy on the edge of the lens. It will like make a few like startup noises because it's a camera. And the shutter release is right here, so that is to the, I'm not gonna say what side it's to, it's just kinda like right here. The flash is here, the flash goes off no matter what. If you're in bright light or if you're in dull, it just always goes off. And there are a lot of different settings you can set your camera on to take the appropriate light picture. A mode for if you're in your house, a mode for if it's cloudy outside, if it's sunny outside, and if it's super sunny outside, like you're on a beach and it's that sunny. And there's a mode called high key. I do not know what that mode means, I'm not gonna lie. I've taken a few pictures on it and they don't come out right, so I don't really know what that means. This camera will give you an LED indication of what mode it thinks you should be in because it does have like a light sensor in it. But if you don't wanna listen to that, you can totally set it to whatever you think. And it just kind of like clicks. And you'll see there's like a little nudge that will show you what mode you should have it in. Like right now I'm inside and it recommends that I should have my camera on inside. But when I point it at my light over there, it says that I should have it on the cloudy mode. So it just depends on the lighting. Then you know all about this camera, let's take a test shot with it and I will print it out for you guys and we'll see how it goes. It's a little bit hard to take selfies on this thing, but I'm gonna try it and we're gonna Instagram it. So let's see how this goes. I don't know how I should pose. I feel like that's gonna come out so uncomfortably awkward, but if it comes out bad, whatever. And it just kind of like prints from the top and it automatically will like, I don't know, it just kind of like comes out. You don't literally do not have to do anything. And the great thing about these new Polaroids versus like the Polaroids from when your parents were kids is that the Polaroids from when our parents were kids was that they had ink physically on the top of it and it would smear and smudge, and that's a little bit of a problem. And now the great thing about these Polaroids is all of the processing happens inside the actual picture, so you can smudge, do whatever you want, and nothing will happen. But I recommend just like kind of like leaving it on a ledge and letting it wait to process, because it takes 10 minutes for it to fully process, but you'll see your image within a few seconds. So there. And I really like the white original film. You can buy all different sorts of film. You can buy Hello Kitty film, tie-dye film, so many different types of film. But I like this film because it's just the basic white, number one. And number two, it has a little area that you can write your own caption at the bottom with a Sharpie or a pen. And my picture is coming out. It's gonna be a little bit longer, I think, but I don't really hate it, so you know. So now I'm assuming that I should show you guys some of my Polaroids and how I take them, so let's do that. I'm gonna pull some out at random and tell you how I took them. Okay, this one right here is one of my favorites. I have Instagrammed this one before, and it's gonna be hard to show you guys them because once again, I don't have a digital copy of them, so I just have the physical one, so I just literally have to show you this. This one I took in Florida of the sky. I don't really know if you can tell, but I was at a resort in Florida over Thanksgiving break, and I took this picture of the sky because it was so cool. There's a sunset in the background and a little fire pit here that you can't tell. It's really dark. The sky was so beautiful. I really take Polaroids to capture memories more than just like to take them for no reason, because the film is expensive. It comes out to like $1 a picture, I'm pretty sure. I buy the 20 pack of film. This is it, and it comes 2 packs of 10 sheets for how much? For $15, I believe, so it's a little less than $1 a photo if you buy it this way. But if you were to just buy it in 10 packs, it's $1 a photo. So definitely buy more and save. That's like the thing. And Amazon is the best, cheapest place. I also took this picture on that Florida trip. I love this one so much. There was a Starbucks in my resort hotel, so I have a picture of my Starbucks and my muffin. And you can see like the palm trees. Oh, so fun. I really like these two. I took them both the same day. My mom actually took them for me. Me in this outfit, I was wearing like a button down, a cute skirt, and I was spinning, and it was outside and it was like a little bit cloudy, so they came out like pretty dark and cool looking. And this is just me. Oh my god, this is also from that same Florida trip. I'm sorry, this is a selfie. I just love it because you can see all the palm trees behind me. I have a baseball cap on backwards and I'm like smiling looking down. Don't ask me how I took this because I really don't know. It just kind of like happened. And it's really cute, I think. I like these two pictures. So this one is one of the dock in my town. It is so pretty and it was so bright out that day and it still came out super clear, and there's like a little lens flare there. So I like that. And you can see like just like the boardwalk and the boats, and it's so pretty and I really like this. And then this one is just a picture that I took with all my friends. I think that Polaroids can also be really fun because they come out with like an interesting effect to them. It's like, you know how on Instagram you pick your effects and it's like, oh, I like this effect for a reason. I like Polaroids because it's kind of like a mystery and you don't know how the effect will turn out, because I feel like it always makes you look better than you actually look with the brightness or something like that. I don't know, it's just something about Polaroid quality pictures that makes you look good, always. So now that I've talked about how I take my Polaroid pictures, how I use that camera, I want to talk about what I do with my Polaroids. Because obviously, I mean, I have a drawer where all those kind of just sit there, but I like to keep some on display in my room. I talked about this in a recent outfit of the week video, but I have an area of my room where I hang up all of my Polaroids, and the way that I do that is by using these clothespins that I got at Michael's. So I just got a huge pack of clothespins and a huge pack of this string, and it's really cool looking string. It's just like vintagey, it's not thin. You definitely want to get like a thicker rope type thing. And you can cut it and measure it on your wall, hang it up with some clothespins. The way that I decorate my room with this is I just string across the string across my room. That really did not make sense. I just kind of like drape the string across my room, and then I use some tacks, put them into my wall in like certain areas. And I mean, it's annoying because you get a hole in your wall, but it's an easy decoration. And I use the clothespin right over the string, so if the string is pulled tight like this, I just kind of like put the clothespin in, and then you can attach your Polaroid to the board, and then the bottom kind of just clamps onto the Polaroid. It doesn't destroy your picture at all, and your Polaroid hangs like this. Obviously, I wouldn't just hang up one, I would hang up at least like a few so that your room looks complete. And I like it because it gives it your room kind of like a vintagey feel. That's really it for today, guys. If you want to see more videos all about Polaroids and more like pictures of mine and how I take them, definitely give this video a huge thumbs up because I love my Polaroids. Make sure you subscribe if you're new to my channel, because I will be doing more videos similar to this soon. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll talk to you all later. Bye guys. Mwah.